Hi, today we're going to be going through the first 15 to 20 minutes of gameplay for The Wild at Heart, which is set to be a Pikmin-like game with a really cute pixel art style. So let's check this one out. Okay, here we go. The Wild at Heart. Start game. New game. Start game. Let's just do the easy mode for this playthrough. Loading screen's fairly cute. Minimalistic. Maybe they're like trying to start a fire. Move that alarm clock. Okay, I'm at home. 15 hours. It's time. Is that 3 o'clock? I'm really bad with 24 hours. Okay, wake. You've prepared for this. Time to enact the plan. You just need to gather my supplies from around the room. I'm assuming. Anything sparkly? Plans. Stack of papers containing various sketches and blueprints, including something entitled Experiment Codename Zool. I might as well bring these other blueprints too, wouldn't want them to be falling in the wrong hands. Gaming system. Hop into your favourite games with the Game Bum Entertainment System. That's cute. It would be kind of weird though, like, because I'm just thinking, like, if I was playing a gaming system that was like that. Oh, it could work. But still, it would be weird to hold. I don't think it would be very ergonomic. Like, I'd go anywhere without my games. Priorities. That's right, wake. You've got your priorities correct. Don't worry, little dudes. Someone will take care of you when I'm gone. Right, there's something else sparkly. Examine. I wish I could take some blockers with me. Some of my best ideas started out with these little guys. Makeshift map. A map of the woods behind Wake's house. Perfect for escaping into them. Definitely to scale. A very detailed map of the forest, complete with landmarks. I'd be super lost without this. Okay, I've got everything from down here. Time to head upstairs. Oh, I love this art style, isn't it pretty? Let's look at this. Okay, there's something glittering over here. Maybe that's just the light. Okay, well, we flushed the toilet. I don't know why it wasn't flushed in the first place. He's gone. I made some field rations this morning before we left. I just need to grab them. I also want to open this. Oh, pick up. Oh, a bag of chomps. I forgot I hid in there. I'll bring them along. Might be handy in a pinch. Okay, must be currency. Nuts and bolts. Geez, the cushion's permanently sunken in with a butt print. He seriously watches too much TV. Just look at the light flooding in under the curtain. How pretty. Pizza? Let's be honest, the food pyramid should basically just be a slice of pizza pointed up. Rations. So, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Okay, can't go wrong with PB&J. These should last a while. Never eaten PB&J. We don't really have it in Australia. It's not something. Maybe they do. It's just not very common. One thing left to do, I guess. What's that? I'm leaving. Not that you care. Don't come looking for me. Wait. Oh, that's a bit sad. Whatever. He probably won't read it anyway. It's time to go. To look at. These are glistening. So I've just got to find the glistening stuff and I'll get nuts and bolts, which who knows what they're used for, but something. I wish I'd had like a feature where if you were nearby it would just like suck to you. Or like just automatically get used. Okay, what's this? Gust Buster. Wake self-constructed vacuum. Used for sucking up all kinds of things. Hold ZR to start vacuuming. Oh, that's exactly what I was just saying it needed, something so if you're standing nearby, you can just get it. Okay, let's kick the trash. And then we can just do a little circle with this and pick it all up. Okay. There's another little pile. Oops. Don't stand in the leaf pile to vacuum it. Where are the leaves going though? Because they seem to be like putting them into his device and then it's like vanishing. But I found the key. A rusty old key for the back gate. It's a wonder this thing has never been permanently misplaced. Is that audio a little loud with the switch? Let's turn it down a notch. Can I kick this? Can I vacuum it? Nope. Let's open the gate. Oh. Right, the day I lost my shadow. I refused to let Dad take it down. I miss you, little dude. Open the gate. Yes. Okay, let's go into the wild. Well, Kirby and I planned this a month. She'll know what to do. I just hope she's able to make it out okay. To get the heck out of here. Loading. Oh, he's skipping. He's so happy. Are we waiting for Kirby? Looks a bit muddy. Must be lots of rain. Well, it is raining. Moonlight Kids presents. He planned this for months. Shouldn't he be excited? Where is he walking to? The wild at heart. Great, I'm lost. How's Kirby gonna find me now? He's like me, Wake. I always get lost as well. I can't seem to find anything. Does Google Maps not work in the forest? Huh? Hello? Who's there? Whoa, what are you? I love how he's not scared of it. He's just like, oh, let's just follow the random mythical creature. So that's, you know, what we do. Generating genius. Oh, there's more of them here. I wonder if these also do the same thing. Give me money or parts. Okay, let's go. Follow the strange creature. Hey! What are these? It's a weird old gate. I wonder if... Oops. Maybe he's in... Maybe he plays Pikmin on his game thing and that's why he's not scared of the monster. That might make sense. Okay. Wait, what's up here? Can I climb this? It's kind of broken right now. Nothing I can do. I can kick it. Nope. Okay. Let's just go. Where are we going? I'm lost. Where'd the Pikmin go? There he is. I'm just gonna call them Pikmin because I don't actually know what to call it. Again. Time for that right now. You do, because you're chasing a strange creature. Why did it fall somewhere that I can't even collect it? Follow him? Well, I guess I'm going in. Hope that little dude isn't just getting me more lost. Here goes nothing. Dud. And then a loading screen. Perfect. He's suspiciously, like, trustworthy of this random mythical creature, though. But that's alright. Oh, is he hurt? Must have been a long way down the fall. It looks surprisingly clean for falling in mud, though. Ugh. What a fall. Now, where am I? In a cave with lanterns. So she let you in after all. Interesting. She was debating for quite some time. Old weirdo. I love his name. Who are you? My folk call me Greycoat. You have entered the deep woods. Few are allowed here, probably. Greycoat? That's your name? I think so. Okay, but your coat is more of a greenish brown. Yeah, like a khaki. This is a different coat. And you are? Wake. 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 What an oddly pleasant name, probably. So indecisive, Greycoat. Oh, hello again. There you are, Brussel. You know good and well that you're not supposed to leave the deep woods. Not every day that a spiritling befriends an outsider. That you can even see them is a feat in itself, probably. You are a strangely small and unwrinkled old man. Are you ill? You should tell me if you are. Wait, I'm not an old man. Russell tells me they found you crying. Why? No, I wasn't. So what? It's rude to sneak up on people. What even is that creature? Didn't he just tell you? Spritling, spiritling. Whoa there, unwrinkled one. There'll be time for questions later, probably. I must hasten to my people. There is so much stuff to be done. Besides the dark, we'll be coming soon, and what is it that we always say about the dark? Who's we? I just met you. Incorrect. We say, the dark is bad. The dark is bad. Okay, good. Let that be your first lesson. Dark is bad. Memorize that. Take this. It is an item most essential to the people of my order. Behold, I give you shiny rock. Oh. I feel like when he says order, he's just like gone into a cult. It's a crystal? I don't know. We call it shiny rock. Shiny rock will guide you, probably. What? Guide me where? Wait. Nature ho! Take me to the place. The foliage. The grove. That's it. I almost forgot what our village was called. That would have been embarrassing. Bye-bye. Oh, he just disappeared. I must be dreaming. Kirby's never gonna believe this. So what's this do? Wait, can you hear me? Crystal is talking? Oh, it's like in Star Wars where they like hold up the thing and shiny rock. It allows communication between all wearers. Does it always feel this weird? You will eventually become used to the side effects of the mind link, probably. Wait, there's a fellow mine up ahead, a member of our order. His name is Scrap Heap. Scrap Heap. Your friend's name is Scrap Heap. Indeed, he will help you, probably. And though traversing the undergrowth may seem daunting, the spritelings are often keen to help. Spritelings, you mean the little yellow guys? Quite so. They are the denizens of this world, and dare I say, part of the deep wood itself. Use them for guidance. They'll know what to do. With your device and their aid, you should easily be able to make it to Scrap Heap, right? No time to waste. Onward. Let's go. I kind of want to get... Do I want to get them? Yeah. Go down. There, hiding in a leaf hole, huh? Cool, cool. Well, you're welcome to join me. The Grey Croak guy said you might be able to help get me out of here. Yay, we got one. Twiglings. These are curious little creatures that can pick up resources, break down walls, attack enemies, and much more. All they need is a little direction. Just throw them near a desired target and they'll get going. Twiglings are fast workers and are immune to toxic gas, but it's also rumoured they can make things grow. But no one's seen it done in quite some time. Okay, so throw them like they're Pikmin. Maybe I can get another friend? Nope. That's alright. Okay, just like Pikmin. Very good. Okay, we've reached a campfire. Save point. Let's just open the map to show you the map. We've made it to the first campsite. I think we'll stop here for this let's play, and that's the first 15-20 minutes of The Wild at Heart. As you can see, it's a very cute, stylized, Pikmin-esque game. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.